And welcome, everybody. Happy Wednesday afternoon. My name is Adam Patrick Murray of PC World. We got Gordon Maung of PC World here. Hey. What's going on, Gordon?
Good.
Yeah, not well, much. We are here for a very special live stream. Usually, we build PCs. We'll do some game streams. I guess we haven't done that in a while. But, you know, like, well, this is a new one for us. We're going to try something that we're calling the TeamViewer Challenge here on this channel. And it is sponsored by none other than TeamViewer, the maker of easy, fast, and secure remote access software. Since 2005, TeamViewer has helped IT professionals and IT-designated family members, like Gordon and myself, troubleshoot hardware and software-related issues on everything from Windows to macOS to iOS to even Android devices. Head over to TeamViewer.com to get started with your remote access and management solution. There is a link in the description. Thank you, TeamViewer, for sponsoring this. I will tell you, this is something that we've been working on for a number of months, and I'm very excited. So, Gordon, let's talk about what we're going to do here. So, a couple months ago, I built a PC. It was in complete, up and running, perfect condition. And then I went through and I did 30 things, both hardware and software, to either break it or significantly slow performance, or just kind of like do things that aren't best practice.
Okay.
I will caveat to everyone out there, you know, we've been teasing this for a while. I will say none of these are to trick Gordon. None of these are in like, oh man, I can't wait to pull one over Gordon. He's never going to get this one. I didn't go into the registry edit. There is thermal paste on the CPU.
Okay.
Nothing game breaking like that. These are all things that I think we have seen in our own experiences troubleshooting friends and family's PCs, or just things that we would consider best practice to keep a PC healthy and running. So Gordon, you know, we've talked about this before, but you personally use TeamViewer to help troubleshoot your friends and family, right?
Yeah, I've actually used it for a number of years because it's awesome to be able to easily remote into somebody else's desktop and just go fix it, and then you're done. And it's because, you know, years and years ago, you had to get in your car, drive all the way over there, take the 5 minutes it was to fix a simple problem, and then you go home. And it's just like terrible. Like,
maybe you get paid with some like some lunch or something.
Maybe
like
you get
that,
paid but, with some know. Lunch. Maybe you don't even get that, because honestly, most of the time, you know, our own time is valuable, and anything that shaves off having to go and help somebody, spending time just to get there, I think is worth it, because that means more time for me to sit on my butt and watch cable TV.
Well, and you even had an experience recently.
Yeah.
So
just this week, so I built an old box for somebody. I repurposed this box. It was running, installed OS, clean build, everything worked fine. Give it to my wife's nephew to bring it up to his sister. She sets it up with his help. Doesn't work. I'm like, oh, come on, really? Like, it was like working just fine, had no issues with it, and now it doesn't work, and it's only because they only drove it. So then I have to get in my car, go all the way over there, walk in the house. I wiggled the RAM because it wiggled loose. You know, you put it in the car, maybe they didn't put it down gently enough. So one of the DIMMs, I wiggled all the RAM, booted right up. And the other thing was like, oh, and the other monitor that wasn't working?
Yeah.
That other monitor's not working. It's like, oh, maybe that was a bad monitor.
Oh.
It's like, no, the power cable was not pushed all the way in.
Oh,
so, classic. You know, that took all of 3 minutes. Less than that, obviously.
Oh, man.
Because then the rest of it was like fixing the cables, putting in this, you know, it just, well, like, if I could have just done that without having to get in my car and go all the way over there, well, would have been worth it.
And some people might be saying, wait, TeamViewer is only, you can remote into a desktop. That's not going to help on hardware. But actually, something that we learned when we've been working with TeamViewer to set this up is they actually have an assist. They call it Assist AR. It's an app you bring up on your phone and you can bring it up and get a feed of what they're seeing on their phone. You can even turn on and off their flashlight. You can annotate on the screen Madden style on their phone to say, yeah. I mean, we're going to show all this too. Like, hey, you know, see this over here, do this, you know, click on that kind of thing. So I would say you know, traditionally, I think most people would think of TeamViewer as like a software solution from one computer to another. But this Assist AR, when we started messing around with it, it's actually pretty cool. Like, I'm excited to show this one. So, yeah, because once again, I did a mixture of hardware and software related things to this system. It's not 50-50. It's a little bit more skewed towards software, but the hardware there, I do want to show people that it's cool to use this Assist AR app to be able to troubleshoot hardware. Because then, yeah, the RAM not being seated, the cable not being plugged in, you don't have to get in your car and go over there. You can have them fire up the app and just send them a code. Yeah, we'll talk about all that when we get in there. But how are things going over there on your end, Willis?
Hey everyone, how's it going? Good to see you all. Everything's looking good. We just got a $5 super chat from our friend of the show, VC Jester.
Oh, friend of the show, thank you.
Saying, I got $20 on Gordon. Don't lose or I'm sending BB over.
Oh, man.
Well, the thing is, what's the success rate here? Because, I mean, the thing is, this challenge, how long are we going to give me? I
got my stopwatch. 30 minutes. Willis is going to control a timer that we're going to put on screen. Yeah. You're going to have your own timer here. We will call a timeout if there's any unforeseen problems.
Okay.
But we've been through the testing of this stream. I will say there are a couple things that obviously, if Gordon is remoting into a friend or family's computer, he's not streaming live to YouTube. So there are a couple things that we kind of, you know, are having to change or gloss over just for the purposes of the stream. But for the most part, I mean, you know, this is everything that you could do on your own.
So. Yeah. And I will say my experience in being able to send a link to relatives or just simply have them download it independently from TeamViewer's website, and then they give me the code, it is, anybody can do it, because if my in-laws can do it, anybody can do it.
Yeah, and I will say that it's there's a free version. You know, obviously there's enterprise here at IDG. We actually do have an enterprise account, but you know, we didn't. This isn't in conjunction with our IT department, but the. There's enterprise level features, there's personal features. The Assist AR is part of that personal
you get a lot of functionality free account too.
Yeah. So be sure to go over to teamviewer.com, look at all the stuff. We're going to use a subset of it here, you know, and hopefully just to have some fun. The goal here is to have some fun, except for Gordon. He's going to take it seriously.
Yeah, I'm going to take it seriously, because I never, any, like, if you've seen my builds, I take them all seriously. I will throw anything overboard to win. So I want to win. If there's 30 things broken, I want to get as close to 30 as I can. But that is a lot, especially jammed into 30 minutes.
Yeah,
typically,
right?
You're fixing a relative's machine. It can take 30 minutes just to fix one thing, because they're usually slow POSs. And then you have to explain them to do stuff. So it goes really, really slowly. We're going to try to jam through 30 fixes if I can find them in 30 minutes. And the best thing is you can help me, because I'm going to be under the clock here, so I'm going to need your help. So watch this stream carefully. If you have advice, please put it in the stream, because, you know, this is going to be a group effort. We're going to beat Adam. We're going to beat Adam here, right?
Because yeah,
you get me to 30 and I win.
And then if you don't get to 30, please help Gordon in the chat. He is allowed to help the chat. Willis actually has the list of 30 items, so maybe Gordon can...
I might throw you a lifeline, Gordon, if you can tell
him.
You know, later on, tell me 3 good things you like about a coupe.
Yeah, we'll see. And then, after the 30 minutes, I'm going to come back in here. We're going to go over how it went, talk a little bit more about TeamViewer, and then call it a day. So... Gordon, are you ready?
I am ready
for this
challenge. And for people to know, Adam is going to convert into any of our friends or family.
I'm gonna be playing a character. I've been working on my character acting skills.
Oh,
this is gonna be fun.
All right, so
this is gonna be fun.
This is not gonna be Adam Patrick Murray who built the machine. This will be his alter ego, who is the person he built the machine
twin. I'm probably saying it's more like pre-Adam.
Pre-Adam.
You know, the Adam at the time that I built my first PC. And I was not knowledgeable at all.
And I have not even seen this machine. In fact, both Willis and Adam have been very careful to make sure I don't even get a glimpse at the desktop or at the machine. I have no idea what I'm walking into, or the hardware.
He doesn't even know what hardware.
So this could be a laptop, but it is a desktop.
It is not. It is not a laptop. Yeah, we did
use a small four-factor box. Oh no, no, I'm gonna save it. Save it. I got my 30 minutes.
You have to.
We have to do 30 minutes, 30 fixes, 30 minutes.
Yep.
A lot of investigation, a lot of fixing. I need your help.
Any last stuff, Wills, before we get started?
No, everyone is excited for us to start.
All right, cool. So, and I will say the 30 minutes doesn't start until you send me that first TeamViewer link. So I'm going to go over there right now. I'm going to get in character. We're going to connect. We're going to kind of do a little bit of preamble in character.
Sure.
And then the challenge starts when you...
Once we're connected to the desk.
Once we're connected.
We're connected to...
Once you send me the link to get troubleshooting. So that sound good?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. I'm gonna assume a different identity, so I'll be back later. Thank you, everybody.
Yeah, so I just want to point out I'm gonna need your help. I don't know, are we gonna go to camera two?
Yep.
So I'm gonna need your help here because, again, I've been around hardware a long time, but I will admit I'm not certainly the best person to fix all advanced problems in the OS. It doesn't matter though, because with the power of Google, I can fix most things, and also the power of the stream. But we are going to be operating under a clock, because once we're going, 30 minutes is not a lot of time, and we're talking about 30 different hardware and software issues on this computer that Adam's alter ego has built. So I'm going to need your help. So please help me. I feel, as somebody who knows their way around a computer, anybody that asks for help, any relative, any friend, I always take as much time as I can to help them, because I think that's what's great about our community. We want more people on the PC, and we're going to be open to helping them as well. So this is kind of
bring.
Who's that?
I think.
Bring.
Hello.
Bring.
Who's this?
Oh, hey, Gordon. Is this Gordon Mong? Hey,
yeah,
how you doing,
yeah, yeah. You got me at a. Yeah, what's going on? Is everything okay?
Oh, hey, man, we haven't talked in a long time. Listen, check this out. I built my first PC. Are you proud of me?
Yes. I remember you asking me if you should build one or buy one, and I said you should probably buy one. But I see you have built a computer.
Yeah, I decided to bite the bullet and do it. I mean, we hadn't seen each other in a while. I'm glad this number still works. I was hoping to catch you.
Yeah, no. So definitely.
Okay, is this a good time? Yeah, well, no, actually it's not. I have a problem. The machine's not working, Gordon. The machine's not working. I thought you were the first person that I thought to call to help me with this. Do you have a minute?
I got some time. How much time do you have?
Well, I've got a meeting that I need to get to in about 30 minutes. So, I need your help. I really hope, you can set aside these 30 minutes to help me.
Not a problem. Not a problem. Oh, I remember that time you asked me when you needed to help move to, and I love helping people move and fixing the equipment. So tell me about this computer you bought, though.
Listen,
or no, you built you built it because you didn't want to buy a pre-built computer, like I said, maybe.
And real quick, Gordon, it's great to chat with you. We haven't chatted in a while, so I appreciate you you helping me out with this. But yeah, so I built this computer. I had a budget, a little under $1,000, and this was last year. I was sitting at home and I was like, let's do a project, and I built a computer. Everything was fine. I was playing Minecraft and Roblox and my favorite game of all time, which is Fortnite, and then it started slowing down. I tried to do a little bit of tuning myself. I heard you could like do things like Undervolt or something like that. I tried to watch some YouTube videos. I tried to watch PC World YouTube videos. There was this one guy who was talking about undervolting. I tried it and it just kind of slowed some things down. So instead of calling you, I had this other friend. He builds his own PCs. He came over and he's like, "Oh, I'm gonna help you fix it." And he just sat there and did some stuff, and kind of changed some stuff. I don't even know what he did. I think he gave me more RAM or something. I don't know. And then ever since then, it just hasn't been acting right. And then, for the past like month or so, it just won't even turn on, and it's making weird sounds. Like, I'm in a real bad spot here. I'm in a real bad spot.
Okay, no, and again, I'm happy to help you fix your computer. Can you? So you about $1,000? Do you know what even the parts are inside of it?
Yeah. I got this really cool NZXT case. It's got RGB. It's like white and black. It's really cool looking.
Okay.
Everybody loves this case.
Great airflow. Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Do you know anything about the parts inside of it? Is it AMD, Intel?
Yeah. It's an AMD. It's an AMD Ryzen system. Okay. So yep. And then I got the GeForce. I got the GeForce in there.
Got
so,
it. Yeah, GeForce.
Yep. So I mostly play at 1080p. I think it's fine.
So
it was fine.
It's slow and it's not booting.
I mean, right now I can't even turn it on. I hit the switch. Okay. It literally does nothing.
Well, you know, so normally I would probably drive over there, but I don't know if I'm going to try to remote. We'll try to fix this remotely because I think it's going to save us a lot of time. Because it's going to count basically to connect your phone. I'm going to send you this link. It can come as a text message or as an email. I'm going to send you a text message. We're going to connect. Then you're going to use your phone to let me
my
see
phone?
This computer.
Really?
Yeah, your phone.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
It's kind of cool. Man. It's like me being there but not having to be there, or spend my money on my gas to get to your house, and also that bridge toll to get.
Oh,
to your
man,
house
technology! Too. I tell you what, technology just keeps getting better and better. All right. So yeah, do you want to send me the code and I'll bring it up on my phone?
All right. So I'm gonna send you the code.
Okay, so yeah, I'm looking at my watch right now. It's about half an hour until my meeting. So, okay. I got the link. Looks like I brought it up on my phone.
I can see your computer now. Oh, I see the NZXT case.
Yeah, isn't it pretty? I mean, look at that. Like, how would you not like that that computer?
Okay. Huh. Interesting. So you're not getting any boot. So when you hit the power button.
Yeah. So the power button's right here.
We're starting the clock, Willis. Clock going.
Clock. Okay.
Yeah, start the
clock
now.
Yeah. So I'm just not even.
So
I'm just
can
not
you?
Even,
so the power cable in back. There's a little switch next to it. Can you?
Uh huh.
Okay. That's a classic. I'm guessing somebody must have bumped that switch somehow.
Okay.
Maybe your cat did it.
Oh yeah, BB. She does like to mess with stuff.
So throw that switch.
Okay.
The other thing I'm also seeing is that power. This is actually very common. I just had this happen to my niece the other day. The power plug wasn't plugged in. That plug looks kind of loose to me. I'm going to say plug that in.
Okay. Let me.
All the way in.
It feels all the way in.
Okay. Yeah. A little bit more. Yeah. See that gap. There should be very little gap there. So get as far as you can go.
I'm gonna unplug it again and just, you know, it can't go in any further.
Okay, that's good. All right, so that's as far as it's gonna go.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure, can you look at the power strip? Because a lot of people will also throw their power strip by accident. I find that happens all the time.
No, it's good. I got some other stuff in it.
Okay,
so
those other things are powered up. Okay, so let's hit the power button.
All right, let's hit the power. Oh, look at that. It's lighting
up.
Okay,
can you point at the monitor now?
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
we got
video card.
I pointed at my monitor here.
Come on.
The monitor is on. I plugged it into something else, so the monitor is good.
So what I'm also... So the monitor, what is that plugged into?
The monitor... Let's see. It's if I can get up under here. I got my HDMI cable.
Okay.
It's an HDMI 1, which is
the
correct
end
port.
Is going...
I will tell you. And the other end's plugged into here.
Okay. So
HDMI. It says HDMI
classic.
Right there.
So unplug that.
Okay. Wait. But I need video.
Yeah. So lower. So wait. Stop. Back up. Stop. Back up. Back up a little bit. Wait.
Okay.
Wait. Stop. Okay. Move to your left a little bit. Okay. Stop. I'm going to see if this works. I'm going to say, a little hard to tell, but I think you're going to want to plug into that one or that one. Here's another one. One of those two.
Whoa.
You see those?
Oh, look at that. Okay. Let me... Yeah, it's not really fitting.
So it is keyed. It is keyed, so just turn it up. It's like a USB cable. It never works on the first or second time. Oh, I'm sorry. You said HDMI. I'm sorry. I'm wrong.
This one's HDMI.
You
want to
go
yep.
here. Go right there. Where number three is on your phone.
Okay, there we go.
Okay.
It's plugged in.
Okay, so do you have anything on the monitor? What do we got?
It just says no display it'll go port into power cable, save
so
mode.
What you need to do is go to the monitor and change the input to HDMI. You're running HDMI, right?
I am running HDMI. Let me this stupid monitor. There we go. Okay. HDMI. Says, and there is no signal coming from my computer.
Okay.
Press any key on the keyboard to wake it up. I got this cool Apple keyboard.
Yeah, no, that's great. Yeah, so you're...
all gamers use it.
And you're sure... Can we just check that connection on the monitor again? Make sure it's plugged in firmly to the HDMI?
Oh, the monitor itself?
Yeah, let's make sure that's plugged in firmly.
That is plugged in firmly. I can confirm.
Okay. So we got nothing. Why don't you power it off and power it back on again?
What, with the button?
Yeah. And then I think... All right, one more. Okay, try it again. Oops.
Man, I'm not feeling good about this.
Okay, go ahead. So what we're going to do now is have you take the side of the case off.
Okay.
So you see the little knob right there? Yeah, there you go. Right there.
Yeah, okay. My friend did this. He took the case off after I built it.
You
want to
be careful because it is glass. And If you drop that, it will shatter into about a billion pieces. So put that in a safe spot. Right. Laying it flat on the ground so it can't fall. Okay. Let's see. Can you stop right there? Hold it. I'm going to...
I got that cool G-force.
Sorry. I'm going to... Let me clear all those other... And then I'm going to take a picture. Hold on. Because now I have a note... let's see. Can you move to your right a little bit? Oh, this is a different issue. Okay. We see the CPU fan isn't spinning either, but why do we have no video here? Actually, move back to your left. There's a couple things that I think we might want to do. We're getting a no post here. I'm going to guess your friend who did the RAM upgrade for you might have caused some problems. So here's a couple things. We're going to start.
Yeah.
I just want to get it to boot first, I think. So this is the RAM. This is the RAM, right? You're going to want to take both of those modules out. I'm going to clear that. You see what I've circled there?
Yeah.
You're going to want to see this little thing here. You're going to want to. I have to say, this is damn cool. You're going to want to push on here and push on here. So like right there. Click on the... Oh, no, stop. No, not yet.
No?
Okay, back up. Kill the power. That little button you switched earlier, kill the power first.
Yeah, good call, Gordon.
No, not that one.
Oh, not that
go
one.
Go to the back and actually hit that back switch. Here. There you go.
Okay.
We're going to wait for all the lights to turn off.
We don't want to accidentally fry Adam.
Okay, now, so what you're going to do, if you just pause for a second again, I'm going to show you what you're going to... You're going to click here. You're going to click here. Actually, wait, let's do the squiggles on this one. So these little things, if you basically toggle those, you can take both RAM modules out. And wait a second. Actually, we're going to leave this. We're going to leave this one in place. I want you to take the one that is here next to it and move it to this slot right there. See? Does that make any sense?
Okay, so I'm moving this one.
Yeah, so the outer pair. That's generally... Yeah, because you might want to... Look at a motherboard, figure it out, but generally all these boards, it's the outer pair I'm finding. So let's just move that piece of RAM that's closest all the way out to the outer pair. Wait, let me look for...
Okay, I did it.
Okay. Now you need to push it all the way in until... Wait, hold on. You're just killing my time here. Sorry. Okay, push the memory all the way in until it clicks, right? Yeah. All these should click shut.
But it's
I don't know, don't knock the machine
computer.
Over.
Okay.
Okay, you can put the phone down. It's okay to put the phone down. I know that's tough for young people to put the phone down.
I got it. Okay. I think it's in. I think it's good. I don't... These ones are just the other ones. See? Yeah, so...
Okay. So are they?
I heard a click.
You heard a click. They're both in place. It looks like we're okay. You know, since we're here, this wire should get plugged into. I can't really see, but do you see if one of these? Let me hang on one second. If you see one of these, if one says CPU fan, oh, so plug it into. Wait a second. You want to plug that into here. It only goes in one way.
Okay.
Right? You can see how that has that notch as though it were 1998, and you plug it in. Very good. I'm guessing your friend upgraded that for you. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I was using the AMD one that had the RGB. He took away the RGB. He said this one was better, but I like the RGB.
Okay.
So, whatever.
Okay. So, now we're going to go back to the back of the computer. Oh, okay. Wait a minute. Let me see what other upgrades your friend did. Can you push on this power to make sure that's firmly in there and make sure that's in? Looks like it's not going to pop out, right? Okay, that's
no, in. I see the little clip thing is good.
Okay. Okay, the other thing is back up a little bit. And see this up here. This is going to be tough to get to, but make sure that is solidly plugged in. Is that? I can't really.
Yeah. I see the clip. It's good.
I thank you for chat. I didn't think about this. Okay, the other thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna have you move lower. Can we see the power supply or is it all hidden? It's hidden. Yeah, modular power supplies. It's entirely possible. What else can we do? How do we get in the NZXT5? Can you get it? You gotta flip it around.
Okay.
Let's see if we're gonna. Yeah, let's. Let's take this side off too. Let's look at the back to see any of the upgrades your friend did. How well does your do you know your friend? Do they really like you? Not like a frenemy kind of thing? Are they jealous?
You know, I mean, he said he was going to upgrade me. I believe him. I think the problem was too is that like he had to run at some point, so I don't think he fully finished. So I tried to plug in some other things that he left, but he didn't. I don't think he finished.
Can you give me
he
a
said
lower?
He was going to come back
so
over.
Hold it. Move the angle lower. I want to look right here. This is a modular. Oh, look at that. It is a. Is this a? Okay. It looks like it's a. Not a modular power supply. So that cannot be an issue. Okay, great. Let's try to post it. Let's try to boot the machine up. Flip it back around the other way. Oh, wait a minute. One other thing I want to check is this area here. If you could zoom in. Can you change the angle? I want to see if. Well, I mean, it works. Wait a minute. Okay, so you're going to want to hold on a second. So I'm going to show you. Is this one is okay? It looks like an 8-pin connector. If you move a little bit to your right, move to your. Okay, stop. Go a higher angle. So this is a 6-pin connector that is plugged into an 8-pin connector. Let's unplug this power connector. So underneath, if you go lower. There's a tab. Okay, you see that tab? Pull on the tab.
Okay.
Now pull the whole thing out. Now you're going to want to, again, I know it's tough for young people to do this, but if you have to do, you can put the phone down. We can put the camera on me. You can plug it in. So you basically need to join both of those together. They are keyed. It is impossible to put it in wrong, but you put that in there. So just, if you can do it with one hand, that'd be great, but you can put your phone down, young people. Oh, okay. Did it click?
I have headphones on, but I think I heard a click. It looks like it went in all the way.
That is a CV. Oh, boy. Oh, it's a 3060 Ti. I was afraid that you had too big of a graphics card for this, but you should be fine with that power supply. I was kind of afraid we needed to. Wow, it's a 3060
I mean, it was working before, you know. It was working before, so. Okay.
So the other thing I'm just now realizing, do you have a screwdriver? Because I'm going to stop,
I do.
Hold it. This video card will work here. It would be better if you actually put it into this slot. So what you're going to need to do is unscrew this screw. Oh, hold on.
Oh, sorry.
So you're going to have to unscrew this screw, right? And then you're going to have to move it to the slot on top.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna have to put my phone down for this one, I think.
Yeah, Willis can switch back to me, or do we want to show?
We can keep it.
I'll try doing it one-handed.
You can put the phone down, young people.
I can't. You know, my boss might be calling me any minute. I don't know how much time left. Okay, yeah. I should be good. I should be good.
So Chad is pointing out the CPU fan is exhaust. At this point, I'm basically almost 8 minutes in. We are not posted. I'm just going to deal with it. If it comes up, even if the airflow is going the wrong way, I don't think it's going to matter. There's no airflow in this case anyway. Plus, look, he's got all the extra airflow from this area, right? So, chat, that's... I know. I'm sorry, Adam, that I'm just talking to my other friend. They're helping me out.
Oh, no worries. Oh, they're helping. Oh, man, that's cool. You got, like, tech support for the tech support.
Yeah, tech support for the tech support. Oh, yes. Yeah. Somebody does point out... this is a good thing. So on the graphics card where we play, hold on one second.
It's not coming out.
Yeah, you just one more screw, and also the cable that we plugged in and back. If you move to the back.
I took the HDMI out.
Oh, nice. Very good.
And this bottom screw doesn't need to be unscrewed.
Oh, okay. So you don't have to lose that. Oh, I thought it was a three wide.
It's just not coming out.
So, okay, pause. Stop. Okay. Just 1 second. So, Adam, so this is a little thing to keep the graphics card from popping out. You're going to have to push that in with... your thumb or your finger, and then it will come out. If you cannot do it, it's fine.
Oh, I did it. Oh, boy. Oh, look at that. All right.
Oh, with one hand, I guess it's all of the...
That's a cool looking card, right? It's got the GeForce.
it's a good graphics card. How much did you pay for that card?
I don't remember. Probably like $600.
Yeah, probably $600.
let's see if I can do this with one hand. There we go. Okay.
Okay, so you're going to have to put the screws back in.
Yeah, let me see if I can do this one hand. Into the graphics card.
And, you know, you can do just one now if you want to skip it to save time, but I can understand if you want to use more time to eat into my 30 minutes. So
well, no, it's my 30 minutes. I got a meeting.
Oh, you got that meeting. Yeah. Yes.
I got that meeting.
Now,
so.
The internet will not judge me as being a failure, but that's true.
All right, I got one screw in.
Okay, you got... go ahead. I mean, yeah, one screw is fine. Okay, take your HDMI cable and please plug it into... Just like on your television or your game console. I understand you used to be a console gamer. Is that what you used
to be? Oh, man, yeah. I still love the Xbox. I've got the Xbox, but then I've got the PC as well.
Yeah.
I do my taxes on the PC, not the Xbox. So.
Okay. Well, I think let's give it a go. So we've got...
Okay.
We did RAM. We got the CPU fan in. Looks like the GPU's powered up. Oh, wait a minute. There's one more area let's check out. Let's look down here. Can I get a close-up of over there? Oh. What the... Amazing. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on 1 second. I'm going to... Okay. I guess they didn't... Your friend did not upgrade your front panel, so that looks like... Let's plug your PC in and see if it... Oh, wait a minute. What is this? Never mind. It'll work without it. There's no screw there.
Oh.
It'll work without
it. Oh, yeah. You know what? I think I lost some screws. It's still fine, right?
Okay. Yeah. I don't suppose you have a hard drive in this computer. Is there a hard drive in the other side?
A hard drive? Give me a view where I put my files.
Yeah, where you put your files. Can you give me a view of the back of it again?
No. Okay. No. Oh, you know what? I got the SSD. I got the SSD in it. It's in here. The
okay,
SSD's in here.
In there.
Yeah.
No hard drive.
Maybe it's down here. I can't remember. It's somewhere on the motherboard.
Okay. There's a bunch of loose stuff up here, and then what is that? Can you give me a view of that?
Yeah, there. Oh yeah, it was also like clicking when I would turn it on. Like I was hearing like this like clicking.
Okay.
So maybe I need to fix some
cables
or something.
So I think it might be. Hang on a second. So I think this. So there's cables that. So that if you can look, there's cables that go from these two fans in front. Uh-huh. And you need to find out where those cables are. No, you can leave those in place. But if you can see they go,
okay,
look around, I think they're just kind of here. If you can find those cables and snake them back in, like see that cable?
I think it's on the other side.
Oh, that's, okay.
We got 14 minutes left.
Oh, yeah, look at this. One of these cables isn't plugged in. I don't know how that happened. But I don't see any other cables up front.
Yeah, so you're going to have to run those cables up to the motherboard and plug them in. But, you know, honestly, it's not going to be a deal breaker if that doesn't... Okay, so you're going to have to plug those cables in for your fans to the motherboard. So, like that fan... Yeah, they're... that's probably some RGB thing. Do we care about the RGB? Okay, so run that. You're gonna have to run that. Willis is the judge here. Do I get dinged if the RGB doesn't get plugged in?
I really need to have RGB. I heard it makes it faster, so.
So you would have, yes. Okay, so you're gonna run that. Yeah, plug that RGB cable in. So snake the RGB cable up to the front, that one. Probably up top, because it's not going to be short enough, long enough to reach the bottom.
Up top?
Where does the fan? Oh, wait, right here. Maybe here. It may go into the fan, the LED controller here. That's where we go.
Oh, okay. Let me.
So you're going to plug that in. Is there another one possibly somewhere?
This one's plugged in. I got this one plugged in already. I guess this one got knocked loose or something.
Yeah, I guess somehow it got okay. Knocked loose.
So that one's plugged in. I've got.
Okay. Okay. RGB is, are there one, any RGB other two. Like connectors lower? 12 minutes.
I mean, I've got all these.
The suspense is building.
Yes. Can you don't have to worry about those. We don't have to worry about that. Is there another? Go up a little bit. Are the fans? Are the front fans plugged in? Wait, hang on. What's this loose one right here? What's that? No? Okay, that's
No, this looks like it connects two fans.
Okay, connects two fans. Where are those fans? Can you flip us around on the side? I'm looking for the...
Well, so this fan, I got a plugs into here.
Oh, okay,
here.
We're powered off the fan control. Okay, good. Let's plug it in and fire it up.
All right.
I mean, I guess... Okay, the clicking noise, you're going to ding that. See this right here? Wait, Adam. Adam, yeah. Sorry. I mean, Adam is okay. Your twin that built the computer for you. You're going to want to take that and just screw it in the front. That should hopefully... address some things.
There we go. Okay, I just kind of jammed it in there, but I think we're good.
All right. It doesn't have to be. Yeah, you know, as long as it's holding in there, and look for any cables that are rubbing on the fans. So you might want to take this cable and move that out of the fan a little bit as much as you can. Although there's a fan guard there, so you're probably okay. So can you move up? I was going to say scroll up. This may, let's tuck that out of the way. That looks like an extra RGB header. I think just tuck that out of the way. Is there something else that's just kind of jamming in the fan blades? Does it look pretty clear? Because you said there was ticking. And then let's look at the CPU fan one more time.
Looks clear to me.
Looks clear. Okay, let's do it. Let's get in the OS here.
All right, I'm going to hit the button.
All right.
I got 10 minutes.
Here it goes.
Oh, no, you have to throw the power in back.
Oh, yeah.
Throw the power in back. There
always
you go.
Forget that one.
Good job.
Always forget
Adam.
That one.
You're getting it.
Okay.
You're getting it.
There we go.
There we go. And
oh, look at that RGB.
We,
oh, man.
We got the RGB.
See, it just lights up so
is
nice.
Is this fan spinning here? Looks like it is.
That fan is spinning. Okay. If I put my finger in it, it hurts.
Okay, and then, yeah, don't stick your finger. How about, any? Are you hearing any of the clicking or anything? No?
No clicking? I'm not hearing any clicking. It sounds much better.
10 minutes.
If I put my fingers in all of them, they hurt.
Okay, great. Are we booting into the operating system?
Oh, I see something. It says,
okay.
It says MAG, like that PlayStation 3 game, massive action game.
Oh, skip. Press a button. We're going to skip the disk checking. I can't afford it now. I got 9 minutes. I can't afford it.
The suspense is building.
Oh, look at that.
Okay, you're into your...
Okay.
Let's see, I got 9 minutes. Can you log in?
Yeah. There's my password. Okay. Sweet.
Okay.
Oh, look at that. Yeah. Awesome.
Oh boy.
You
so
know,
I'm going to send you another link as I can... Because, you know, you can relax now, 8 a.m.
Okay.
I'm going to send you another link.
Oh. Okay.
Are we getting... So do you have... Can you look up... Is there in...
I'm getting all these pop-ups.
Okay. Up here, is there internet? So you're going to say no. We're going to say no to BattleNet because I don't have time. And then do you have internet connection? Does it look like you if you look up there?
Yeah, I'm just getting all these pop-ups.
Yeah, you have to install every single tool you have. Look up here. So I'm important. Do I have internet access here? Can you look up here? Do you see anything?
What am I looking for?
Okay, you got internet access. Okay, I'm going to send you a link.
Okay.
You want to switch back to me... Willis, I'm going to send Adam a link because I need access to the desktop. I got 8 minutes here.
All right.
Okay.
Switch to you.
All right. So you send me a link. Do you want to send that over to my Gmail? Yeah.
Yeah. So a link will come in your Gmail. You're going to click on it. You're going to, just like
on
your.
Oh, I see it. Okay, I see it. Let me click on this link real quick.
All right, Jason.
No, we're gonna stay on me. He's gonna log. Okay. Adam is going to log in now. I got 8 minutes. This is not going to be easy.
8 minutes, Gordon.
I got 8 minutes.
This.
Okay, I'm gonna hit the link. All right, it says download TeamViewer. Yeah.
Yeah. Get the download TeamViewer. You're going to log in.
Okay, it's very easy. Opening it up now. Okay. It says have the partner join the session.
Okay, I'm going to do that. Connecting is going to, usually what will happen is it'll ask for code that's on your screen to make sure that it's connecting.
They would like to control my desktop, view and control my desktop. Do I want to allow that?
Yes, please allow that.
Okay, I allowed it. Okay.
Okay. All right.
Are you in? Can you see me?
I'm in. I'm going to
is it safe to switch back?
Okay. So you have, I'm going to accept all cookies because I have no time. You can go back to, you can switch back.
Okay. All right.
Oh, actually, how do I get to? Oh, this is so weird. Sorry.
Oh yeah, I switched from a Mac, so I like, you know, I like the stuff at the top. I heard you can't do that in Windows 11, so I'm sticking on Windows 10.
Okay, so I don't. Let's. I need to. So it's gonna. You're gonna see me, Adam. Don't worry. It's me. I'm the one who's controlling this.
Okay.
And you are seeing me control your. So I'm just going to disable some things in your startup.
Oh, wait, but I need to have my music. Don't get rid of my music.
Yeah, it's okay. I think I'm just trying to slow, because I think some of the problems is some things are a little bit slow. I see you. It's okay. We're just going to disable a few things here.
Oh, but I got to use my Photoshop. I mean.
Yeah, you can still use it. Actually, the funny thing is you can still use all of these things. I know this is a little hard because you may have come from console and Mac, but you don't have to enable or install every single thing. So it's fine. We're just going to turn some NZXT cam software. I would turn that off too. It's fine too. Although, yeah, we're going to, but I'm going to disable just a few things, maybe a dozen or 20 of them. And then we're going to. 5 minutes. I got 5 minutes.
5 minutes on the clock.
Oh yeah, sorry. I've got that call in 5 minutes. So if you can go quicker, that would be good.
Yeah. No, I mean I should be, you know, hanging out with my family right now, but it's good. You're right. I should move faster for you. I do understand that is.
Yeah, my time is valuable. I don't know if you know this, but I'm like, you know, I have a good job now. So.
Yeah, no, I understand. Let's see. I want to unlock the taskbar.
Gordon is sweating a little bit.
Because I'm like, I can't get out of this bizarre configuration he's done on the top. You know what? I gotta.
Oh no, I have this thing. It says your PC might be at risk.
Yeah.
You want me to hit scan?
Yeah. Don't do anything. I'm driving right now. It's fine. I'm just trying to get to. I can't even close this browser window out here. Okay, what in the world?
Oh.
4 minutes. I got 4 minutes.
Should I call my friend? Is that...
I'm just trying to... your friend, the one that unplugged a bunch of stuff. I mean, the one that moved all the components around for you. I just gonna... Why can't I not
relocate?
He's
the one who said the GeForce was better.
Yeah. Good Lord, this is bizarre. It's like, is this in like tablet mode or something? What is going on here?
No, I can't touch my screen.
Yeah, no, I'm just trying to figure out. This is, wow. This
is. Oh, it says I have viruses, man. Okay. I don't know. I'm kind of scared.
Okay, the other thing is your drive is kind of full, so I'm going to...
Oh.
Yeah, that,
oh, yeah.
That's
huh.
probably...
Yeah. I tried to install Call of Duty, and it said I didn't have space.
T-minus 3 minutes.
I got 3 minutes.
Yeah, sorry, I got a call in 3 minutes. It's
it's not enough. It's not just a full can here. What in the world do you just have?
Like I said, my video games, man. I got a lot of video games. Okay, so I'm gonna text my boss real quick. I'm gonna see if I can get a little more time before the meeting.
Okay. I'm just gonna, this drive, really, we're gonna have to uninstall some games. You're gonna have to get a bigger.
Red Dead, I was like halfway through that.
So you have no space left. You could either lose Halo Infinite. You could either have a slow system or get rid of one of these games. Halo Infinite or Red Dead.
Man, Halo sucks. Let's get rid of Halo.
Okay, I'm with you on that. Yeah. We're going to get rid of it. I don't even understand the fascination with that game, so...
It's Halo.
I have to say, I'm really stuck with this bizarre screen configuration. What is going on here, chat? Any ideas? What in the world is like... I can't even get to the desktop here. What in the hell...
Okay, you know, I just heard back from my boss. I got 15 more minutes. Is that going to work? Do you think you could?
We're going to go 15 minutes. 15 minutes. We're going to clean this up. It's going to be sparkly clean. But okay, what?
Oh, okay, awesome, sweet.
I'm really at a loss here for some of these.
Yeah, he said. I don't want to lose my job here, but he said 15 minutes is cool. So you know, I don't know if I doubt I can go further than that.
Okay.
60 seconds.
No, we're gonna go extra quarter.
All right, I'll wait for that timer to close out.
So we've installed. So we're gonna. Is there anything else you can get rid of here that we could?
Oh no, I need everything.
I can't get rid of this bizarre. What is he doing here? This is a really good one, Adam. This is a really good one.
I don't know. Yeah, it just.
Yeah,
like
I guess
I can
go to
I came
show.
From the Mac. I like the. I like it to be at the top, like Max.
I get it. I understand that. That's your thing. I am actually going to. We are going to taskbar manager. No, my God, I'm just totally broken. This is insane. This is really insane.
Man, see, I was hoping you could help me. I mean, like I said, even before I couldn't turn it on, it just wasn't it wasn't working right.
I'm gonna have to reset the timer.
It's not even responding now.
That's my Steam.
Yeah, it's not even responding at this point now. I'm just it's stuck.
I'm seeing a Steam thing, and it says that I have to type my password in for Steam again.
I'm seeing Microsoft OneDrive, deleted files removed everywhere.
Oh, you know, let me stop this real quick. I'm just gonna hit exit on this.
Somebody wants me.
Okay, there we go.
Wait,
restarting.
You want
minutes?
Me to fire up disk part and disk one clean? Yeah, I guess we should look at the swap file. I'm just totally thrown by like this is just stuck, man. It's not going anywhere. Your machine is just jammed. Are you seeing anything on your desktop moving?
Yeah, I see you like mousing around.
Let's do a reboot on your box.
Okay. All right.
Can you reboot it from there? Because I can't.
Yeah,
actually, let me see if I can do it. We'll just do a restart. Let's see if we can.
Right,
yeah,
restart.
I'm not even getting a.
All right, I'm restarting it. Man, I gotta say, Gordon, I thought you were better at PCs. I'm hoping you could really help.
Yeah. So we're gonna reboot the machine. Let's see if we're running a little any faster.
If you want to, I still have my phone showing. So I don't know if you need to do that.
Let's look at it from there, because.
So my phone connection is still. Going.
Why don't you switch to me, Willis, and we'll hit space bar.
Oh, okay.
Should I just let that disk check go? I don't. Yeah, I can't even get to the desktop on this thing. It's insane.
Okay, let me put in my super secret password. All right, so should I use that same link that you sent me before?
Yes, please do.
Okay, I'm going to have to set my phone down for that. One second.
Yeah, please do. Put it.
Okay.
Well, so chat, I basically disabled like 40 things he had in startup. So I think that should help. I'm just really thrown for a loop trying to get to the desktop on this thing. I mean, I don't know how like to get out of full screen with the menu at the top. I mean, who actually does that? People do.
Like I said, man, it's like a Mac. It's just my favorite. I like it to be like a Mac.
You know, and I will agree because chat is saying, you know what? That's your problem. It's going now. I got the machine booted. We're in the OS. I got to find as many things. I got to get as close to 30 here.
Or it says, please wait until connecting to partner.
Oh, got it.
All right. Do you have me?
No, not yet. I was not paying attention. I was looking at chat. We were commiserating.
Okay. I'm gonna allow.
This is actually very realistic. Okay. We're good, right? We're here.
Yes. Can you see everything now?
Okay. I can switch it back now. We're good.
Okay,
what the
so
hell
yeah,
is this thing?
All right, I'm gonna switch back to screen. All right.
So I'm sorry. I'm just gonna sort your desktops by date modified.
Okay. Yeah.
So what I need to do? So look, so it's gonna pop up.
Okay.
There
you
are.
If you need me to do anything, let me know.
Yeah, no, just chill out, just relax, okay. Maybe have a beer. I mean, I'm having so much fun here.
Yeah, I mean, and once again, I think I have, I'm not quite sure how much time I have left.
11 minutes.
11,
me,
okay, yeah,
minutes
my boss said in 12 minutes, don't get me fired, please. I really need your help on this one.
Is it an important job?
I am, yes.
Where do you work? Burger King or McDonald's is one.
No, I'm I cold call people to help donate money to my university. It's very important because the universities need more money. I got really close to being employee of the month one month.
Yeah. Chat, I got out of desktop mode from the reboot because whatever was running the full screen is out now, apparently. So we're good there. I hope I'm uninstalling. So I'm going to uninstall some of that free antivirus stuff for you. And then what browser do you use mostly?
It's just the one that was that one that you're looking at, AVG Secure Browser.
So
I heard it was the most secure.
Okay, you like that browser?
I really care about my privacy. You know,
so you want to use that.
The AVG is just, you know, I've heard it's the best. I didn't look up it on PCWorld.com or anything.
So what's BitTrip Runner?
Oh, it's one of my favorite video games.
Because I can't nuke that. We're at least, and I'm guessing all these games and you use GOG. Okay, is there anything else? Chat, I'm like, okay, you have Norton 360 and you have, are you paying for Norton 360 right now? Is it actually?
No, it came with the computer parts and I was using it and then it stopped and that's why I downloaded AVG.
Okay, so if you're not using it anymore, I'm getting rid of it because it's probably not paid for. We're just going to nuke it right now.
10 minutes remaining.
I got 10 minutes here.
Oh yeah, my boss just said, don't forget to bring the donuts in 10 minutes.
Oh, okay.
So yeah.
Boss is a great boss, I guess.
You should bring him Wendy's.
Huh, interesting. Your Rockstar thing still loaded with computer sites. We're just going to turn that off. It'll still work. It's fine. Let's just unload some of the stuff.
Oh yeah, I'm just texting my boss right now. I'm telling him that I'm working with like the famous Gordon Mong, and he said, "Oh, Gordon Mong from Boot Magazine. Yeah, he used to read you, and then he stopped.
Yeah, he got
you were like
him.
Mean about Macs or something.
Yeah, because yeah, no, I got it. So you really want to use? So we're gonna stick with the AVG browser because you absolutely.
Yeah, I've heard it's the most secured. Yeah.
You don't want to try any other Edge or Chrome or Firefox. You're just going to stick with it. That's your personal preference. And I think What else can we get? What about this Proton VPN?
I always use a VPN. I've heard it's secure. Okay, you gotta use VPN.
I can't get rid of that. I'm basically disabling. Do you use the Yahoo toolbar?
No, I don't even know what that is.
Okay, good. Yes. Oftentimes when I'm surfing the internet and I get a thing that pops up and says, do you want to install? It's hard to resist clicking the install button, but you should try not to.
Most of the time that it pops up and it says yes or no, I always just say yes. It's just, I don't have time to think about it.
Okay. So it looks like, let's see. It's uninstall. Good Lord, Norton, how long are you going to take to finish that? We are going to, 7 minutes. I still got 7 minutes. I think
My boss. Yeah, 7 minutes.
So oh, you man, said I'm, you I'm, work I'm, at a donut shop? Is that what you're saying?
No, I wish. No, I call people and ask them for money for my university.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because universities need more money. So
I don't know what. Oh, it's Corsair, Wavelink. You know what? We're just going to. So, and then we're going to disable. I'm sorry. I'm just going to disable some of these services. Your machine is a little slow, so I'm just going to. I don't. GitHub. What are you running from GitHub? Probably okay. We're going to lose that. What's Signal RGB?
Oh, I don't know, but it's I like RGB, so it sounds like I need RGB.
I don't Internet, think I did that one. Has anybody heard of that one?
I think my friend did that
Signal
one.
Signal RGB.
There's a third party. Oh, okay. Third party. Okay. Well, I guess you're kind of stuck.
I got to have my RGB.
You got to have your RGB. You can control with the other tools, but I mean, I guess if that is what you are running and the RGB is working. So, I mean, then, okay. And you use.
I mean, it's glowing.
Okay. I'm going to keep this locked the way you had it before. And you run Discord. You need to have Discord running.
I'm in this Discord channel called The Full Nerd. And there's some weird people in there, but
it's the best channel ever.
Yeah, I like it for the cat memes, to tell you the truth. I just look at the cat memes.
Oh, okay, great. Let's see. The other thing is, I'm going to see if everything else is working in the machine. And then, come on. Okay. Oh, wait, you also have Chrome installed on your machine as well.
Oh, okay. That's the Google one, right?
Yeah, it is indeed. No, it's defaulting to Yahoo. Almost 5 minutes.
Yeah, my boss. I'm texting with him. I'm a little worried, but I think he's cool. As long as I bring donuts, I think he might be cool.
Okay, great. I just want to. So you said the machine's a little slow. You mean just a little slow,
Like I was playing games, and it was just like really slow, and especially when I would start up, it would just take forever. But
Pretty recent graphics driver. Wait.
I like my gaming. I mostly do gaming. Like I said, I do my taxes. But mostly games. Sometimes I'll watch YouTube or the Twitch.
I will say I'm impressed. You have, it seems to be identifying your graphics card as a 3090. Is that?
Oh, no way. maybe my friend unlocked the power of this 3060 Ti. Maybe there was a program that he ran that said 3090.
Huh, interesting. I'm just going to download drivers for a 3060. 4 minutes.
Okay, four minutes, yeah.
3060 okay. Ti, right? We're running Windows
10.
Yeah,
I mean, that's the one I have. If you do you have an extra 3090? Like, could you give me one?
Unfortunately, I can't give
it
away.
I heard you review them, so yeah. I heard you could just give me one, right?
Yeah, that's how it always works. Yes, that's how it works. Okay. Unfortunately, it doesn't really work that way. It's very interesting how the driver's identifying itself as a third.
Hey, listen, I mean, if you ever want to sell me one, you know, I've got like $20.
Yes, that would also be something that would get me fired as well forever. Wait, is there one that says that? Internet? I don't think. We don't want to look at the... Wow, this is crazy. 3 minutes. But if I can get... It's what's weird though. Check this out, internet. So we're gonna go do. Right, we're gonna do. Wait, where's my HW info? Did it run? Oh God. Two minutes.
Yeah. 2 minutes.
Oh, the driver's still downloading.
Yeah. Oh man.
What kind of internet do you have? It must be pretty slow.
I'm wired in. I wish I got the Wi-Fi, but my friend said I don't have the Wi-Fi. So. Yeah, it's a bummer. Do you have a Wi-Fi you can give me?
A Wi-Fi I can give you?
Yeah, like I put it in my PC and it makes Wi-Fi.
What in the world is this? Oh wait, that's the downloader. I'm gonna do a clean install of drivers.
Oh, okay. I mean, is that as long as I can play Fortnite?
Yes. So I just don't understand. It's interesting that. That's a cool one. Look, see, chat, look at that. That's just sneaky. I don't even know how that's even possible. But Wi-Fi, you're doing great. Everybody should play gaming over wireless. 802.11b, in fact. I'm just kidding. You should probably get an Ethernet cable and plug this thing into the wall.
Well, I did. I don't have the Wi-Fi, so if you can give me a Wi-Fi, that'd be awesome.
So, okay, BitTrip. So you play all this. You play BitTrip, you play...
I don't play the BitTrip, but it's fun. It's like my favorite.
Again, let's keep it on there because I think we're in a little better shape. We're going to do a clean install of the graphics driver.
1 minute left.
And... we got 40 gigs free. I can't really. Let's do a.
Oh, you know, I think my boss might call me in a minute.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I'm really worried. Hopefully, I don't get in trouble.
Oh, well, man. I mean, I would hate to stop you from cold calling people at night while
you're
eating
dinner.
Yeah,
I think the other problem is that I usually like when I'm supposed to work, I'll play Fortnite. So hopefully, I just don't want him to find out.
Okay.
So.
Huh. I'm not.
If he calls, I'll put him on speaker, and you know, just don't say anything, okay?
And that's time.
Oh, wait. So I'm gonna see if this works. Did it work? We're gonna reboot. Start this reboot.
Bring, 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 bring.
Oh. Bring, hey, hold on. I got a call. I got a call real quick,
bring,
Gordon.
Bring, bring, bring.
Hello.
Hey, Adam.
Hey, I am so sorry I'm late to this meeting. I promise I'm going to get donuts. I got this guy who's going to like try to help me fix my PC. It's a little bit broken. He doesn't quite know what he's doing, but he should be done soon. I promise.
That's okay, because I'm actually stuck in traffic right now. I should be there in about maybe 5 minutes.
5 minutes. Okay. I'll tell my guy that he's got 5 minutes. If he doesn't, I mean... Yeah, then I'll probably...
Yeah, make sure you get those donuts. Mad. We're going to meet with Steve from Gamer Nexus and... yeah.
Yes.
Oh, an influencer. I love influencers. Yeah, we got to get them to donate
big,
to my... Yeah, they got to get to donate to our or university. Okay, cool.
All right. Yep. See you in five.
Sounds good. All right. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. All right. So I'm gonna log back in. Hey, Gordon. Gordon, are you still there?
Yes. Yes, I'm. So I didn't hear anything of your conversation with your boss.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So I just need to pick up Jones. He said he's stuck in traffic. So I've literally just got 5 minutes. So like I really need you to be done. With this. So let me.
Yeah,
let me
I'm connect. Sorry. I'm sorry. It's taking so long. Out of my day to help you. I apologize for that sincerely. Yes.
Yeah, I was really hoping you could help me. I mean, you've done some stuff, so at least you got it running. I guess that's good, right?
Yeah, no, we're up and running. I want to run a couple things, and then if you could log back in, because I did update that driver. I want to see if that's going to fix it.
Sorry, it took a second for the internet. Okay, so now it says I'm ready to connect. Okay.
Okay, let's see. Did that work? Let's see if we're gonna...
Let me know when you're ready, Gordon.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead.
Okay.
Oh, this is insane how the windows are aligned like this. I can't deal with it. I cannot deal with it. Why is this? I can't deal with it. I can't deal with it. Just can't do it. So the problem is it stacks. Okay. All right. What are we gonna do now? So look, we now have our 3060 Ti working. With the even know how that happened. How did that happen?
The 3060 Ti.
Let's just download malware bytes free. I love malware bytes.
You want me to download malware?
No, I'm going to go ahead and we're just. You know what?
Okay.
You don't have to touch anything. Okay. What else could possibly be wrong here? Let's see what we've got running. Okay. You know what? Okay. I'm going to leave this weather thing on because those people. I can drag this.
I got to know the weather.
Look, we are. What the heck? Okay.
I mean, I mean, it's doing pretty good.
Yeah. No, it seems like it's definitely running a little better. Would you agree?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, so far, like, at least when it launched, it didn't, like, launch all these pop-ups. That was always annoying. But I had to keep it up to date.
So the pop-ups are mostly gone, and you know what? Let's do this other thing. Oh, well, okay. So you're really committed to that browser that you're going to run.
I mean, I've heard it's the most secure,
Because if you're not, but the thing is, I'm also going to change your, you want to use Yahoo. I can't stop that. That's not my problem. That's your thing. You can't pass judgment. I would recommend you use either Chrome or Edge. Even Firefox. Okay, I got 3 minutes.
I got to get the donuts. My boss loves maple bars. He's just a fiend for maple bars. So I got to get those maple bars, Gordon.
Ryzen 5 5600. Does this all look right? How many? Oh, wait. Let's see. Wait. Okay, we got 6 cores. Is SMT off? Let's see. There shouldn't be any BIOS things. I need to send a control delete because
I don't know what a BIOS thing is.
Oh, don't worry about that. Don't worry your sweet head about that. It's all okay. It's all going to be just fine.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Okay. We got 12 cores. Okay. 16 gigs of RAM. SSD is in place. Graphics card is there. We're running Ethernet. Okay.
So close.
2 minutes.
What else could... Yeah. I mean, I think... still downloading. But it looks like it's actually operating. I do want to... I don't know. Any other ideas? I mean, I could run just a general sweep for malware, but I actually think... I'm not seeing any kind of odd behavior. Right? Ryzen Master's on there, though. You're saying Somebody wants me to check Ryzen Master here. I'm going to check Ryzen.
Oh, yeah, I did an undervolt. I heard PCWorld.
I got 1 minute and 20 seconds. Yes, this is why regular people should not talk about it and influence people that shouldn't. Okay.
So, yeah, I undervolted. I just didn't want it to get hot.
I was going to run Cinebench. I ain't got time. Nope, it's not the test. We're just going to apply, fire it up. Yeah.
60 seconds.
60 seconds.
Oh, yeah, I got to go inside. Literally, just, you know, I got my keys ready in the car.
Should I go into the BIOS? No, I don't think I got time. I think generally.
I don't even know what a BIOS is.
Okay. We're on auto. Our curve optimizer is off. Everything is like, okay, great. I think, you know what? I think 30 seconds. Oh, you're right. No.
What
afterburner?
I gotta go. I'm so sorry.
Okay, I'm sorry. You gotta go to your work at the donut store.
I mean, I got a minute. I mean, how much time? You know, let
seven,
me look at my clock.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right, I gotta go. Gordon, thank you so much. It was great. I probably won't talk to you again for another couple of years, but I appreciate it. You know.
Yeah. No, I'm glad I helped you. The good thing is you do only live 45 miles away from me.
Sorry, I gotta go. Gordon, I gotta go. I'm sorry, I gotta go. Right, bye. Bye. Thank you.
So much appreciation. Okay.
How you feeling, Gordon?
That crazy taskbar thing was killing me, absolutely killing me. But how many? So what's the count there? Because I feel like I got at least 15. I feel like I'm above 50%.
Definitely hey, above 15%.
Hey, what's up, man? How'd it go?
Hey, I was talking to your friend Adam. Yeah. Oh, Adam,
how'd it go?
Yeah, it was it was really fun. But the nice thing is,
oh man, oh Gordon,
I did not have to drive 45 miles to his house to fix some of the problems. Oh. I do appreciate that because I'm sure he would have compensated me for my gas.
Sounds like a jerk, but okay. You got really stuck on the taskbar being at the top.
I was like, you know, I just got to move it. You know, so the problem is it just threw me because you're overlaid because it's under a little bit of an underlay with because you're looking at it in a window and it was just like, which? And just like, I could not because it was hiding the actual ability to exit out of full screen mode.
I tell you what, like that was.
And I wasn't sure, like, I know, I don't know if I can send. Let me see. Can I send a?
Yeah, I was like, oh man, this is going to be hilarious because like I don't know anybody personally that puts the taskbar at the top.
Actually, there are people who do it, and that is an actual real world. Because I was like, wait, how do I send a? I was like, how in that world do I send a? You know, a full screen. I don't like. I forget. And I was so one of the things is I'm not 100% familiar with. What commands are so there's what's cool about TeamViewer is you can pass things like you saw me pass out
the actions I think
you
yeah,
can
yeah.
under actions I don't know if there is an action to pass
there is yeah oh. yeah there is
but it was just kind of like this is insane like I was like I couldn't find I was like I'm like I gotta get because oh, the thing that gets you is the clock because the thing that is unrealistic about this is there when you go to help somebody for free on your own dime they never usher you out of their house. Like you could stay there for 5 hours and they don't mind because they're basically getting free tech support.
Yeah, true.
To be on a clock is not realistic. So that was like, you are really feeling the pressure when you're under the clock.
I got to say, you got almost all of them. You got
really?
Almost
so
all
wait,
of them.
Wait, wait,
except
what's
for,
the list?
Except for you went over 20 minutes. So
yeah, that's true. But what?
Way over 20 minutes.
There is no way. Let me ask you, like, how in the world does somebody set up 3060 Ti as a 3090 card? right?
Well, I don't know. I don't know about that. I don't know what you were seeing there. What you saw when you went to go down the GeForce drivers.
It was showing. You did not.
I didn't do that. Yeah.
So I fixed something you inadvertently did to the machine.
Yeah. I think that's a bonus.
I legit don't know.
So let's start with hardware. The RAM. Yeah. I put the RAM in the two front slots closest to the CPU. You got that one. Obviously, the GPU was in the wrong slot, and I had unplugged the...
Okay.
The
got it.
The tail, so it was 4 and 6, and you fix that. I thought you weren't going to see that one. I thought that was going to be the one to trip you up. I was plugged into the IGP when I first started. Yep. I mean that was easy.
Got that one easy.
Fan cable. Yeah, obviously. Well, I had unplugged the CPU fan cable.
Right.
So you saw that one, but also you didn't have me fix the fan because it was an exhaust. It wasn't pushing across. That's okay. You saw it, but you didn't
have me
fix it.
I was not. Yeah. I don't even care about that one.
The front fan RGB controller was unplugged. Obviously the bracket was undone. And just kind of loose.
Okay.
And it was clicking. Maybe you couldn't hear it over my headset mic that I was using, but like that was the one that was causing the clicking.
Okay.
The power supply switch was off.
Right.
That was an easy one.
Classic. True classic.
Front fan LED, front shroud, CPU fan backwards. Okay. Yeah. So you got most of the hardware stuff except for you didn't have me swap the CPU fan. So yeah, good job on there. And then I would say the number one on my list, and I'm surprised you didn't go there, is that you didn't check Windows update settings.
Oh yeah. You know what? Yeah. I was like, cause by that time you're like, wow, cause it did go a little slower than I thought it would be. Cause that was a lot of hardware. I mean, they were pretty simple, but having to explain somebody how to do it and then having them one hand it with their phone is a little tough. So
Windows updates was like the first one I thought you'd go to, that you would just go in, immediately go to settings, update, and make sure the Windows updates, it's a good thing to, hey, check your latest, Windows updates. So you got that one. Taskbar on top, and I locked the taskbar so it didn't auto hide.
Yeah.
That one definitely tripped you up. I was surprised by that. The time settings. So I actually changed the time settings. Not that that was a huge thing, but the time settings were off.
Yeah, no, that can be a problem. Time settings.
I was actually hoping... by the time that I broke it and by the time that we plugged it in, it did update something. So the date was right, but the time was wrong. I had actually changed the date.
Got it.
I also had auto gameplay capture on, so it was automatically recording the screen.
Oh. Wait, what were you running?
I can't remember. I don't have it on my notes here.
I think it was either
GeForce or the Xbox overlay.
I think I removed everything from startup.
Oh, dude. Yeah. So I was like, oh, that was one of the things that I was so excited, because I literally loaded on all these apps and auto start all these apps. And then you didn't see it. I was so bummed that you didn't see it.
Which
but
one?
I had auto big picture mode for Steam startup. But when it did, somehow it broke you didn't actually see big picture mode.
No, I was getting a weird UI issue.
So that's why I kind of went in and I threw you a bone on that one. Exited big picture mode.
That is one weakness of physically not sitting in front of a computer. It would be a lot easier because you are looking at it in an overlay and there's other windows.
I mean, you could have had me go to the app. I was surprised that you didn't have me like show the screen on some of those, like, because I was still running on my phone.
That would have been a good idea, right? Hey, pick up the phone, show me the screen.
Right.
Because again, the real value though is like, realistically, people will ask you to drive 45 miles to their house to do something, right? And then it's like, okay, that's like $10 in gas. It's $20 in gas in California.
I had disabled the antivirus and loaded up AVG and Norton. Norton had expired. AVG like had a bunch of,
I think I uninstalled both of those.
And then the AVG browser was sent us. My character, even though he said it was the most secure, that was just, I'm not saying AVG is the most secure. That was just, I put it on there.
Yeah. And it's one of those things where I swear to God, people like why is it every time I come here, Yahoo is set as your homepage? I'm like, okay. So you know what?
I set Yahoo as my homepage.
And I'm talking about like over the last 20 years of my life.
And the, exactly. The taskbar. You know what? I tried really hard to get a bunch of like taskbars in one of the browsers. They don't really make them like that anymore. You know, like usually you get this like thick ass header of like all these like taskbar. You know, kind of things on the browser. I tried really hard. It didn't work.
I had some relatives that might give you some advice on how to do that. So.
Yeah, that one was out of my league. Bing wallpaper, which I've heard. It wasn't a huge thing, but it can slow it down. But also, I forgot that when you remote in, it actually blacks out the desktop picture. So
yeah, no, that's a good one. And honestly, but again, that.
But being wallpaper, I mean, having it run in the background, like I have heard some things that it'll chew into performance. You know,
and then also, honestly, like I basically, because of the time constraints, I went and basically took a flamethrower to it all. Like, honestly, if somebody wants to run the NZXT control panel for to monitor temps, that's like, I can't make that call to disable it, but... You know, unrealistically, because there's that clock. I'm like, you know what? If you're complaining about performance, it's going overboard. So,
you got the one at the end where I went in and manually underclocked in Ryzen Master.
Yeah, that was a chat because I was like, wait a minute. They're like,
so I manually set it to well, and you even brought up Task Manager. I thought you would see it when you looked at the performance tab. You were like, oh, I've got all six cores, but it said it was running at 1.7 gigahertz. I figured it was just basically. You would see there.
I was basically thinking it was,
but I'd manually set it to 1.7 gigahertz.
Okay.
So, because if you would have, you know, played any game or I knew you wanted to go to Cinebench, so if you were going to run Cinebench at 1.7 gigahertz locked, your score would have been like jacked. So, yeah. I knew you were going to go to Cinebench.
I was going to see it there, and then the only problem I think was like R20 takes a little bit longer to run. I should have just gone with 15, which then I could have run that in a sec. Smaller to download. And
Signal RGB, it's not a problem, but yeah, I did have it, you know, run and kind of like control some stuff. The full hard drive, you know what's funny? It is hard to fill up a hard drive. I tell you what, like that's why the BitTrip Runner and BitTrip Beat, they're like each one of them's like 200 megabytes.
Oh,
you know what I mean? So because I was just like trying to get to that line of like zero, but then even then there was still some caching stuff. So when we logged in, I think there was like. What 2.7 gigs free, but last time I broke it, it said zero, you know, almost zero. So
how big was that drive again? That
you had? Half a terabyte, 500 gigabyte. There was that. And then the Razer Cortex, I download, you know, when you download Razer drivers, they always ask you if you want to like load Cortex and all those like game stuff. Yeah. I had installed all those, but you had killed it in the startup, so when you had me reboot, you didn't see it the subsequent times.
I think that problem is sort of like you can get, I probably should have run this in windowed mode, but we did it full screen because we wanted people to be able to see more of the screen, right?
Yeah.
I were running it windowed, I think it would have been a little easier on me, frankly, because we did run this sort of exaggerated.
Yeah, and once again, this is like very interesting, you know, funny kind of random way to do this. Once again, you know, usually you're not under time constraint. Usually you can get it. And I mean, we talked about this too. Usually you would remote into somebody's system and just be like, oh, hey, you know, you can go ahead and step away. I'm just going to work on it, right?
Yeah, and honestly, one of the problems with most people's computers you're doing free work for is they are dirt slow. So it's like, hey, I'm doing this, you know, I'm going to check for malware. I'm going to check for these other issues. Just come back. I'll call you on your phone when I'm done, or I need you to manually reboot it or something, or to plug it back in. I would generally, then you would do this. You would do your own check, walk away, you know, and come back in 30 minutes. So this is very nice because you can, from the comfort of your own home, you can tech support people's computers for free instead of like, oh, let me tell you how many times you're just sitting at there, you're in their office and you're just thumb twiddling because you're waiting for the slow full hard drive to do a disk check or whatever. And you just like, oh, I
almost did put a hard drive system in there. Like I almost did it on a hard drive, but I was like, you know what? No. That's literally going to put everything into a crawl. You know, I wanted to give you a chance. So that's why I was like, I'm going to slow down.
It would have been so slow.
Yeah. So like I didn't also say I did load up a VPN to auto start, but that was going to mess with the connection as well, you know, and that probably would have tripped you up for a while. So yeah, there was definitely some things, and I did get some really good recommendations from like VC Jester and stuff like that to like what to do to mess with it, but I really tried to keep it, you know, like
they
like,
were very realistic. Although yeah. I wouldn't, well, the undervolting thing, I'm not so sure people are going to do.
That one's a little bit of a stretch. Yeah. And I don't think anybody would like mess up undervolting that bad, but yeah, I had to throw that one in there. That was my one little thing just to, cause well, I knew you were going to run Cinebench. I knew you wanted to go over at Cinebench.
Yeah, cause I wanted to get a metric for like, okay, if he's complaining about performance, I at least wanted to get some baseline of performance.
And some people were saying, oh, look for the EVGA, you know, yeah, precision boost or things like that. I was gonna underclock the GPU, but I knew you weren't gonna go to test any games or any GPU related stuff. I knew you were gonna go to Cinebench. So I decided to limit the CPU rather than the GPU.
Yeah, and somebody points out a gigantic page file would have been funny as well. And I think I was like, you know, it's kind of like one of the things I wanted.
Oh, I don't
to
even
think
know
about,
how to do
but,
that.
Well, you just go and manually set the page file to some stupid size, I guess. But it would just be,
yeah, I feel like that one's a maybe, yeah, like,
well, I mean, even the undervolting thing, one of the issues with, especially say somebody younger, is they go watch a video and they're like, hey, I saw my favorite person do this on the internet, I'm gonna do the same thing. Don't boot no more. They screw something in BIOS. They screw,
well, and then which is why I actually don't like to undervolt in the BIOS, because you can mess with startups. I always like to do the software in the OS, because if that case, you can just do a reboot and right, it, you know, typically it'll clear the system.
But you know, I mean, but again, and I want to point this out, if somebody had screwed up the BIOS, you didn't do any BIOS.
I did
screw
not.
Ups here.
I thought about it, but I was like, you know what? Because then you would have been sitting there. The problem was too, you would have had to been on the, you know, on the phone connection, which is not bad. I mean, it's cool. You can still see the phone. I was like, you know what? The BIOS is just a little too far out. There's plenty I can do in the OS.
Yeah.
To mess.
And
to
it
mess
is
it up.
Pretty rare for people to, you know, randomly screw it up. But again, it does. It's not unrealistic because
true. Yeah.
You know, kids like, oh, it must be perfectly safe because Adam says it's perfect. And then it's not that safe. So it does happen.
I want to talk about for a second that app, the Assist AR app. We've talked about this. I hope everybody in the chat kind of saw how cool that was, because you were annotating on the screen.
God, that was,
and it was staying in 3D space. Because when I'll give you a little behind the scenes, when we were talking with TeamViewer about setting this up, they were like, oh yeah, we'd love if you use the Assist AR app. And we were like, oh, okay, sure, we'll check it out. And you know, like, oh, you annotate on the screen. I was like, okay, you know, I guess that's going to be kind of cool. And then we fired it up just to test it out, and we're like, oh my god, like, wow, you can actually, like, it stays in 3D space. I for sure thought it was like, oh, you can annotate on a screen, but then if you move, it's just going to be a circle on a screen. It stays in 3D space, and you can drop those little arrows,
right?
And they stay there. Those arrows stayed with the GPU, because you dropped the arrows when you were talking about the HDMI inputs, and then as I was going around, even like moving away from the screen, like it stayed. Like, I'm super impressed by that app.
Yeah.
We talked about this before too. I helped a family member build a PC during the pandemic, you know, and we did it over Zoom, and man, it was a pain in the butt. And once I learned about this, I was like, oh wow, this would have been so much easier if I could have been like, hey, I'm going to send you a code, you know, a link, you know, get this on your phone.
Right.
And if I could have been able to annotate on the screen or drop little arrows like that. And also you didn't use the one feature that I was hoping to show off, which was the flashlight.
Oh,
if it gets dark, if it gets dark in there, you can manually trigger the flashlight on the phone on.
Yeah.
So that you can see inside. And like, that would have been a godsend if I was helping, my family member build a PC a couple years ago.
You know, I think it's also probably not emphasized as much because, you know, when I am telling you know what I'm talking about. Like, oh, this fan header.
It's hard to get. Yeah, I tried not to
you
really
tried
tank
not
it.
To,
yeah,
not to tank it.
Because I could have tanked it. And,
but realistically, though, when you're trying to tell a relative, like, you need to plug this in to here. Oh my God, like, that is the most difficult thing in the world. Like, just take this, and they say, what wire? There's wires everywhere. Because I, like, my sister, when we have conversations, it's always a shouting match, because it immediately goes into the shouting match mode. But if to be able
what
just
wire?
To say, like,
what, I plugged
this
it in.
Wire right here into this to here, just, I mean, I really think that, really, for the people who really don't know their way around a computer, That is really a game changer. Because I was like, you know, yeah, you could do this over whatever favorite, you know, video conferencing platform, but they're not really made to do that. And that, I know it sounds like, well, I know Gordon's just saying this because, like, think about what we did there. I just said, move this RAM slot to this RAM slot. And if you're just telling your, you know, 14-year-old friend's son to do that, they can look at, they know exactly what to do. I really
and,
think
and
that's
and I did,
awesome.
I didn't really do it on my end. I should have done it on my end too, but I can draw on the screen and be like, wait, Gordon, you mean here?
Yeah.
And he would have been able to see it too. Like, so right. it goes both ways. Like I could have annotated on the screen as well. So it's super cool. Super cool. One of those things where, you know, in the process of setting all this up, you know, we have both used TeamViewer, the, you know, the desktop app plenty, but that assist AR function was just like, wow, okay.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
So, definitely.
Yeah.
So what was my final count? I know that I went over time, but what was the...
tally?
I think like 28. I think you got 28, except for you went 20 minutes over.
I went 20 minutes over.
So, you know, it was a good effort. You got pretty much all the way there.
Yeah. I got all the hard... I feel like I got... All the hardware stuff, except for without one thing that whatever.
And I like that you looked for the module power supply, because I intentionally used a non-modular one, because I thought, I was like, you know what, Gordon's going to be like, oh, you shouldn't use. And you did say that. You were like, oh, I bet you kids and your non-modular or your modular power supplies. I intentionally put that in there because I was like, Gordon's going to be like, oh, wow, okay,
well,
cool.
And that is, you know, and honestly, that is a real problem people have, because I'm not throwing shade at modular, but if they don't seat it all the way and then you've got this power supply buried in the guts of that computer, now you got to tell them to basically rip that power supply out of there. There's no way that's a, you know, 5-minute job. You know, it's just going to take more time.
Yeah.
So.
And you know, honestly, though, I would say, even though you didn't get every exact little thing, like, you got the system back to where, like, you know, it didn't,
right.
Like, the major ones were performance loss, like the underclocking, you know, all those pop-ups. Except for a couple still popped up. But yeah, I mean, for the most part, you got there. Like, you know, that person who was in there could have just started playing Fortnite again and you know, so Gordon, I'm not
I
gonna,
like the bonus, though. I got the bonus.
You did get a bonus. So you know what? I'm going to give you a prize. When we were in Texas, I got a little keychain that says, ooh, come and take it, with a little cannon on it. So there you go, Gordon.
Oh, why, thank you.
A little prize.
This represents the cannon. Well, there's a long story here. You have to watch
long
the podcast.
Story.
Yeah.
We can talk about it later. But so did everyone have a good time? I wasn't able to really watch chat, but Willis, how did it go?
Everyone loved it. I'm going to go through quickly and sincerely with you know, some of the comments and super chats.
Okay, thank you.
That, you know, from real quick. Who's in the name? Gordon is employee of the month every day.
Oh, there you
every
go.
Every day.
At the donut store. At the donut store.
Amazing, right? And... through super chat, VC Jester, $5.
Thank you so much.
This was just from a little before, but pro tip, you can slide the little connector in first, then the big one, then they don't need to go in at the same time. Assuming something from the
that's true for the PCIe power.
Yeah, you know.
They used to be set up so you would join them all together, but you know, let's not do that anymore.
a generic account for $6.99 Canadian dollars.
Ooh,
when my grandmother was alive, I suspect she used to brick her machine on purpose so that I would come over more often.
You know what? That's cool. A bad idea. If I have kids,
sweet.
I'm gonna have to do that.
How did the power supply cable? How did the power supply cable get pulled out of the motherboard, Grandma? It's like, I don't know. Maybe.
Hey,
it's
by
the
way, Gordon, you don't usually come over often enough. I want to see you more.
That is a good one. That's a really good one.
That's a pretty good
it's,
one.
Yes, it's Munchausen by proxy is what it's actually formally called, but. You know, you brick your computer just to get attention from your lousy, no good kids that don't come over to see you. So.
And another $5 super chat from J.W. Dickinson. Here's $5 for entertaining me. This was amazing. Also sad because it hits so close to home.
Oh, yeah. Right.
And
you know,
so many people can relate to this.
And like,
know?
I said, that's why I didn't want to do anything like malicious or like really like, oh, I'm going to trick Gordon. You know, like I really wanted to show things that either I've seen or that anybody could like. The only one that's a stretch is the underclocking one. Sure. You know, but for the most part, the rest of them were like things that you could easily see. Also, you didn't notice that my downloads folder. I just, you know, I always like
it
to keep
full.
I like to keep a clean downloads folder.
folder, and I hate it. You know, you always, you know, go to download something, and you're like, oh my goodness, do you ever clean out your downloads folder?
Yeah, and I will say when I fix people's computers, like, you know, relatives, like, do you need all these? You got to ask first. You can't delete things because they want to keep it, but. I thought about, like, I'm just going to nuke everything, but then also, you know what? Just felt like you gotta let people, they want to live that lifestyle. You can't change
true.
It.
True, and I was going to try to, like, put so many files on the desktop that it starts to, like, layer, you know, like that thing, like, oh my, I have seen people, I know people.
Oh, my desktop's like that.
No.
Right? You've seen it. I keep every single icon on the desktop.
I've seen bits of
and
it.
And then
yeah.
I just put it's them not on that
bad.
Into a folder.
I would say it's not that bad.
Not bad.
But it's,
yeah, no.
It's okay. It's close.
But I mean, I think that's, I none of this is unrealistic. I mean, like, even that horror show of the UI, that's actually some people, that's what they end up with. And I think that's anybody who does free tech support, then you're like, oh my God, what is going on here? And it really, that is, I mean, that's not, there's nothing here that's unrealistic. So to get 28 out of 30, although it took a little longer, I think that's pretty good. And I got that bonus, 3091.
Yeah, you got a bonus. I think you did end up fixing a couple things that weren't even broken. But yeah, so you did good. You got the Texas keychain prize. But yeah, no, this, oh, sorry.
I'm sorry. Well, I just want to point out a few more. So from Dr. Ian Cutress, Tech Potato.
Oh, Tech Potato.
Says, my home PC taskbar is at the top, only because stuff on my desktop cover bits of the taskbar if it's at the bottom. So, you know, he intentionally made everything, you know, put the taskbar on
I
top
get
because it.
It covers I get it, but I would just never admit to that in public.
Yeah, well, okay, so now we do know somebody that does that.
Exactly.
Who was here that's a Southpaw? Was it, it was Ryan, or was it, it was Ryan. Ryan Stroud is a Southpaw.
Oh, no, he inverts his controls.
Oh, no, he's worse than
a
Southpaw.
Yeah, he's an inverter.
He's an inverted controller.
So when you move your mouse up, it goes down.
Yeah.
For
shooters. Okay. Yeah, for first-person shooters, right.
I would, like, I should have fixed that. You should have inverted the mouse. See, now that would be mean. Right?
No, but that would have been,
that's not realistic.
Well, maybe.
Somebody flip the UI to where it's, you know, horizontal? Yeah. I mean, yeah. They could, honestly.
So actually, this also, I did have another one set in here, but I actually did have a little bit over 30 because I think that, like I said, the VPN one, I turned off. Also, I did have the UI scaling set to 300%, but for some reason it didn't click. It defaulted defaulted back to normal UI scaling. Cause
that would have been easy to fix, though, because it would have, although I kind of wonder what that would have done. I mean, it probably would have made it really weird, but
yeah. I think when you connected it didn't. Yeah. So, but anyway, yeah. Oh man,
it'd be a good podcast for the future where we get people to tell us their worst.
Oh, we
tech
should
support
do that.
Nightmares.
Worst tech support nightmares.
You tell
us
because because they really are just like, oh my God, what happened here?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. Oh, but anyway, this has been awesome. Oh, sorry, you got one more.
Two more super chats. Ian washes $5 Canadian for the donuts. That was great. Rewatch it, was multitasking but felt the stress through it.
Oh my,
good show.
Sweating bullets there.
Yeah, and then also $10 from LaSalle Rhymes the Third.
Ooh,
friend of the show. Great show, thank you guys so much. One more comment from Sean C at PC World. I miss color coded wires.
I do too. I don't understand why we had to do the all black wires, and nobody likes that, but like, I like color coded wires.
I knew you would like that I use that H510. Because I was like, you know what?
Yeah.
If you're remoting it to a friend or family member, almost, you know, 50-50, it's going to be one of those H510 boxes.
It is an immensely popular case. And I did throw I had to do it for the internet and say, yeah, it's got great airflow. I did say that. So.
And then a $5 super chat from Denerva 1G1. Thank you so much. Said screen orientation is a real thing. Control Alt Arrow can change screen orientation on many Intel video drivers.
Huh. Okay. No, that's a good one. And you know, people, they pound their keyboards like a random, like a 2-year-old at the piano. So I can see like somehow they flip it upside down and they don't know how to unflip it, right?
I thought you were going to say something funny about the Apple keyboard. I intentionally connected an Apple keyboard. to it. I mean, not that it matters. But
Yeah. I mean, although the thing about Apple, people with Apple keyboards is that squiggly thing that they have, I mean, the command key. Yeah. The command key, if you don't have an Apple keyboard and you're using it on a PC, it gets a little weird.
I will say we do use it on the streaming machine, but that's because it's a very quiet keyboard. Yes. I actually do like it over here. So.
Okay.
Yeah. But you have any more? Or you're good? Okay. So yeah, anyway, thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in. Thank you, Gordon, for doing this. I knew you were going to be stressed out. Hopefully you didn't get your heart rate up too much. We're actually going to go eat barbecue. We have barbecue waiting for us. The company bought barbecue for
Wanting, I've actually bought this test equipment that measures, measures. Oh, I guess you got to touch it, but I want to measure heart rate and respiration when you, cause I bought this equipment cause I wanted to be able to measure, power use, all kinds of things, temperature, and then also heart rate and respiration at the same time. So we could do like gaming and then measure respiration and like a, do that with tech support.
That would
support,
be funny. Oh, that man, really yeah, is. Yeah. So I mean, if you enjoyed watching the, oh, and thank you, Willis, for the switch in and the
anytime
the fun times.
And being the boss for a minute, Colin.
Oh yeah, that was fun. We had kind of pre-scripted some of that stuff. Yeah. So yeah, just in case we happen.
Yeah,
oh,
that was good. I like that boss thing.
And a $5 super chat from a friend of the show, VC Jester. Thank you so much. I know your boss, Adam. Have him call me next time. I'm internet famous with 14 Twitter followers. Yes, that was awesome. That was fun. And if it was entertaining, thank you so much. Let TeamViewer know that this is entertaining by clicking on that link. There's a link in the description, or you just go over to TeamViewer.com, and try this out too. Like, it really is powerful stuff that we use personally. This is one of those great sponsorships that actually lines up really well because this is fun. We've already talked about potentially doing some other TeamViewer stuff in the future. So help us out if you liked this. Let us know what kind of stuff we could do in the future too, because we had fun. We actually had a lot of ideas going into this, so there's a lot of potential stuff we could do. So
yeah,
hopefully we get to work with TeamViewer again in the future to do this. So and thank you to them for sponsoring this and for sponsoring the past two full nerds.
Yeah.
So I think that's it. And thank you, everybody, for watching and trying to help Gordon. I did have a little bit of an eye on the chat, and I could see people were in there. They're trying to help. So
that was actually very difficult because I was like,
to manage both. I knew it'd be a little hard
because the clock is like, oh, the clock
puts
the
stress on you.
Yeah, people don't realize like watching chat definitely disconnects you from whatever you're doing. Like the people who play on Twitch and like are able to manage playing a game and watching chat at the same time, like that is a skill. That is a hard one. So thank you, everybody. I guess we're gonna call it here. We're gonna go eat some barbecue. We have some barbecue. So yeah, thanks again, Willis. Thank you again, Gordon. Hopefully your heart's
it's calmed
still
down
ticking.
A little bit.
Yeah. Thank you, TeamViewer. Thank you, everyone, for watching. We'll be back with the full nerd next week. We've got other cool videos lined up. So we will see you later. Bye.